Hi, my name is Stephen Phillips. Welcome to my YouTube channel. Replacing the 1TB hard drive on my Humax Freeview player box. I didn't have a 1TB SATA hard drive, but in my garage I had a 320GB SATA hard drive which I'd actually used on one of my old desktop computers. Other items I used to replace it were some plastic spudgers and pry tools and a Phillips screwdriver. So here we are. I've got the Humax box, disconnected it, put it on my desk. As I said, it's a Humax FVP 5000T, and it was 1TB. Well, I was going to buy a new 1TB drive, but I've decided this is the second Humax box I've got where the actual hard drives failed. In the last one, I replaced the hard drive, and that lasted about a year or so, and then it went. So I've got basically only a 320GB one. And I'm just going to put this in just to test it out, really. It's a SATA Western Digito. So let me see what happens. So I'm going to move on and let's see. Okay. I'm going to have to break the warranty seal to get into it. So let's do that first. There, I can feel the screw underneath. Right, so I've just pushed a screwdriver through the warranty seal. So let's undo that first. That's it, that's unwrapped the seal as well. So one screw. Okay, let's move on now. I'm going to check there's some clips, I believe, holding this in position 1, 2, 3, 4. So let me try and undo them. Right, yeah, there's some clips in here I'm trying to undo with these little prizes. And I'm sort of thinking, by the look of it, I've got to get to unclip it and then get a tool in here. Okay, I'll go on second. Yeah, there was actually a clip there as well. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 clips. So let's that's it. That's the lid off it, eh? So there it is. My my hard drive. Just got FVP 5000T, 1TB. Toshiba, 1TB. Yeah. So let's have a look at it. Okay, July 2019. Yeah. Okay. Let's see if I can take it apart now. So let's wait. Move on. Okay, I'm going to remove this clip here, which is retaining the hard drive on. And this is where I'm going to have to undo the four clips. This four. Well, let me see. I think I've got to remove that screws. They must screw in the bottom of the hard drive. So let's go. I'm trying not to get in the way of a camera. Take those out because there's no nothing holding them. No seal there, so that's them out of the way. What if I can get that out with a hook them up that little magnet there? That's it done. Okay, now I'm gonna break this seal. Same process. I'm gonna support it at the bottom now, just in case it wants to fall out. One. Let's have a look. See if I really did have to undo those screws. Certainly feels loose in there. Probably slides out from a SATA connection. Let's have a feel. There, slid in there, that's it. That's completely out now. And yeah, it looks like the screws did line up with these holes here. Okay, that's some match up a SATA connection. Certainly they're similar by the look of it. Yeah, looks like it. Let's slide this in then. This would be the big. Let's just try the. I think it is probably in by the look of it. Went in quicker than I thought. At least I know what I'm up against. I'm going to put this clip back in. Since that's there. I think 2 terabytes. Well, I'm not sure if that'd fit this, but I mean, as I said, I was going to get 1 terabyte. But I thought, what if I get the 1 terabyte and it still doesn't work? You know, especially with my experience with Humax and hard drives failing after so long. Is it worth it, you know? Is it better to buy a new box? So I'm going to try this some new hard drive, well, it's second-hand hard drive. It was in my computer before, so it's a secondary sort of drive. So let me just get that. Right, that's in. Okay. So, that's the thing to remember. There's only that one screw, and then those 4 retaining clips. Plastic clips holding it, which I did research YouTube before, to be honest. And I thought, well, that seems different. But you do have to remove these hard drive screws as well eventually, but best to do that when it's open. Oh, the screws are tightened up even. That's a miracle, isn't it? Right, okay, I'm still going. Right, that's that done. Okay, that looks good, doesn't it? Right, now I'm going to test it out. Can I be brave? And I might not put the cover on first of all, so let me pause this. Okay, let me pause it again. Right, it's back on. Let me have a look. 298 gigabyte available. User usage 0. System usage 0. So whether I'm not sure if that's a good sign or not, but I'm going to try and format it now. So say yes and see what happens. Put my secret code in. I bet no one knows what that is. There we go, and let's go. And off it goes. Right, okay. I don't suppose it's going to be giving me any indication of the progress. So I'm going to pause that again so we don't have to wait. I missed that message, but it just said the storage has been formatted. Okay. And then promptly disconnected the HDMI, signal's gone. So not sure what happened then, but let me see. Maybe it's turned off. It's gone red, isn't it? Okay. Yeah, it's restarted now. So I did that automatically, actually. So let me go here. It's time starting up. Okay. All right, may hopefully come up with a picture in a minute. Still firing up. It sort of went on the screen went off for a few seconds, so Maybe it's because it's had the new hard drive formatted and it's just resetting everything. Alright, okay, here we go. So, that's come up, okay. Now let me just go back to the top again. As it does that, it goes off. Yeah, it's still waiting for the, well, yeah, I'm not connected to the internet anyway, yeah. Oh, was it? Oh, well, I actually did forget to connect to the internet because then again, I've only formatted the hard drive. So maybe, yeah, maybe it's remembered my settings to log onto the internet here by the look of it. So let's look at it again. I want to do a hard drive test because last time it didn't want to do the hard drive. It just said it kept clicking, which is living dangerously. But so I've done a format. I'm going to go into that menu, the hard drive. Format HD test. Wonder if I can do that. This will take a few minutes. Let's see. Ah, that's better now. It's come up with a total storage 298.1, 25.4 gigabyte system usage, 0.2 gigabyte user usage, 272.5 gigabyte. Not a lot, I know, but it's better than me buying a brand new 1 terabyte drive and it falling over. I mean, I may struggle on with this if it does work and worry about it later, whether I need to either gamble away and buying a 1 or 2 terabyte drive. But my problem is with the 1 terabyte, I filled it completely up to the brim. It was at about 97% storage with 3% left, which probably was the system usage, whatever. So and after that all my programs disappeared and I couldn't record anything and it wouldn't let me get the programs to delete them. So whether that caused it to fail, I don't know. But anyway, let's pause this a minute. Okay, it says passed HDD test, no defects are found. Literally, the old one, it used to do that at first. So let me do okay. Right, let's get out of the menu, go backwards in the menu, keep going back and go back. Okay, I've turned the volume down because I didn't want to. So now what I'm going to do, let me do a rewind. It may not do it for a second. Let me see. Yeah, there's not a lot on. Okay, that's done that. Let's go forward. Now, okay, is that going to live? Right, now I'm just going to try a quick record of some of this. Not a lot, but I want 30 seconds. Right, I started to record and we'll give it just about a minute maybe, just listen if I can. I don't want to hang around here much longer now. It keeps it functional for a little while longer. Okay, it's not quite a minute. I'm watching my clock up the top there. Watching the clock here. Okay, that seems plenty. Let's just press that to see if it's yeah, it's got the record on there working. Okay, I'm gonna stop it now. Recording has been stopped. All right, okay, let's go back to the menu again. Up the top, recordings, let's have a look at that. Now last time it never used to work, so let's try this. Come on, play this recording. No, watch from the beginning. There's a lot on it. Live Stephanie's packed lunch. Okay. Well, I think it's working. You know, I think it's working. I mean. Oh man, I was a little bit impatient with that, I know. Play this recording. What's from the beginning? That's what I want. Sorry about this, going backwards and forwards. I know I'm a time waster. Ah, oh, where is it? I've gone to about a minute mark. I think it's okay. I'm going to record, delete that recording. Yeah, we'll delete that. That's that gone. Go to storage again. Storage. No recordings, and it's got, I've got 58 hours or SD 155 hours, so that'll have to do for me. Anyway, thank you for watching this video. I'll upload it later, and it's going to be rough and ready, I'm afraid. But anyway, thank you for watching. This is a view of the top cover and the bottom housing, which has got the second-hand 320 gigabyte hard drive installed. A close-up view of the bottom housing, where you can see the 320 gigabyte second-hand drive installed. Here's a view of the top cover looking underneath. As you can see, there's five actually retaining clips, one of them in each corner and one in the middle at the front. I hope my video was short and sweet, and that's about it. As always, the video was for guidance only. Just to confirm, there were five clips holding a top cover on the DVR, which you, once you remove the security screw, you have to unclip all those five clips. And thanks for everyone who managed to watch until the end. 10 out of 10. Bye.